By almost all metrics, Bitcoin looks incredibly healthy and strong, with new highs in the near future a seeming inevitability. However, there are genuine concerns surrounding Bitcoin's future when analyzing a number of potentially concerning data points. So let's get straight into it by looking at the miner revenue in fees chart we have here on BitcoinMagazinePro.com. And what we can see is if we just zoom in on these miner revenue in fees, and this is BTC denominated revenue, we can see recently we had a BTC miner earnings throughout the entire day of 2.63 Bitcoin for the entire day just in fees. Now this is actually an incredibly low amount of BTC revenue, and we actually have to go all the way back here till 2012, March the 3rd, 2012, since we've had a value that low, which is understandably a little concerning, especially considering we're now having Bitcoin halving events, which are practically making the block reward in terms of BTC not a negligible amount at the minute, but going forward, it is going to be a growing concern that the amount of incentive for BTC miners in terms of block reward, fee incentives is diminishing substantially. If we just go over here to look at the mempool for Bitcoin, what we can see is the high priority sats per byte is about 30 cents. This means for about 30 cents, you could practically guarantee a space in a Bitcoin block for your transaction for a practically unlimited amount of money. Now, this is incredibly low, and the amount of transactions actually coming through on the Bitcoin blockchain continues to decrease. What we can see here is the mempool size in bytes, and I think you can actually see it fully there. So I'll just bring it this way a little bit. And what we can see is this has reached pretty much all-time lows, or at least matching all-time lows. What we can see is, if I can just grab that here, no, I'll just bring it this way a little bit. There we go. What we can see is looking at the mempool size in bytes, even though we've recently had a little bit of a spike, especially after the launch of ordinals and their brief success, we've now come back down all the way to practically zero in terms of the mempool size. Now, this is something we typically don't see at this stage in a cycle. Usually during a Bitcoin bull cycle, when price is rallying towards new all-time highs, we have a lot of transactions. We have a lot of on-chain activity. This is then reflected in the amount of miner revenue in fees that are generated. But at the minute, there's almost no revenue in fees. There is almost no on-chain activity. The mempool is practically empty. If you actually look at the Bitcoin blockchain, there'll be many blocks going through that are a vast majority of just empty space. There's not enough transactions to fill the blocks. What we can do here is also looking at this data point. This pretty much solidifies that, looking at the confirmed payments per day. This is on blockchain.com. And what we can see is this has been in a very steady downtrend pretty much for the past couple years. We can see that this is of course cyclical. Once Bitcoin's price is trending upwards, we usually see more payments per day, more people using Bitcoin, and this is reflected in the underlying price of Bitcoin. Same is true for the downside. Once we see these big Bitcoin bear markets, when we see price really having these extended drawdowns, this is when fewer and fewer people are using Bitcoin. But as I said, we're now approaching new all-time highs. We're above $100,000. Seemingly everything looks great, yet very few people are actually using actual on-chain Bitcoin for their transactions. However, one thing we can look at is the estimated transaction value in terms of USD per block. What we can see is, looking at this here, this shows a slightly different story. Whereas historically we've had pretty low values, recently we've actually had some pretty big spikes. So what I've done is get this data point here, and what we can see is I've created this chart, which is the value per day in blocks. So what we can see is, even though the amount of transactions coming through is decreasing, the average USD value per block per day is actually rapidly increasing. So even though we are seeing fewer and fewer transactions, we are seeing every transaction that is going through being worth substantially more. This is just a 30-day average of the data. If I get on the raw data here, it gets a little bit out of hand. But I think this is just a natural progression for Bitcoin. I think we are likely to see Bitcoin slowly transition away from this peer-to-peer electronic cash narrative into this global store of value and this means of international large-scale settlements. If we just look at something like the Puel multiple, we can see that miner earnings, when looking at the USD-denominated miner earnings on the day, or on this day compared to the 365-day previous average, we can see that this is still well above one. So even though we are seeing fewer and fewer BTC generated in terms of revenue from fees, this is made up because the amount of Bitcoin that is being generated through the block reward is making up for these losses, especially given the fact that Bitcoin has had a pretty rapid price ascension over the past few weeks and months. But like I said, at the minute, this may not be a major concern, but going forward, this may become a little bit more of a problem. If we look at the miner revenue in the fees versus rewards charts, we can see that currently it's about 98% of all miner revenue is generated by the block reward. But we can see that this is generally going to trend to the upside. As Bitcoin's block rewards diminishes from 6.25 to now 3.125 to again in about 2 years' time, it's going to decrease once again by about 50%. This is slightly alarming. What we can also do is if we go over to TradingView using the Bitcoin Magazine Pro indicator here for miner earnings, what we can see is the miner earnings in fees, again in BTC denominated terms, so we can see the general downtrend that we've seen in this. But of course, this is in BTC denominated terms. If we look in the USD valuated terms, and again, if I turn the graph into logarithmic rather than linear, we can see that right now it's not too concerning. But as I said, most of this is being driven by the astronomical price increase we've seen in Bitcoin. And again, if I change this from fees to the total amount, we can see that the miner earnings in total USD denominated terms is somewhere around $50 million. Now, this is actually significantly higher than what we've seen for pretty much all of Bitcoin's history, excluding the all-time highs and big rallies we saw in the previous epoch before our most recent halving event. We can see that this has been a historically large amount of Bitcoin miner earnings. What we can see is if we go to this chart here, assuming miners want to keep a consistent $50 million in revenue in daily earnings, we can see after each epoch, after each halving event, what the Bitcoin price would have to be to sustain that. So we can see right now, after the most recent halving event where the block reward dropped to 3.125 Bitcoin, we would need the price of Bitcoin to hover around $111,000 to actually maintain this $50 million in revenue. Now, of course, this is going to fluctuate depending on the competitiveness of miners, the actual underlying reward in fees, but we can see this is currently negligible. But going forward, once we see the Bitcoin block reward again decrease by 50% in 2028, we need the Bitcoin price to be around $222,000 to maintain this revenue, which would give us a market cap of about $4.6 trillion, which again seems somewhat reasonable, seems optimistic, but I would say definitely achievable as an average throughout the next Bitcoin halving event. But if you look forward to something like 2040, we would need Bitcoin's price to be about $1.7-1.8 million to maintain this $50 million a day revenue for miners, which would lead to a market cap of around $37 trillion, about twice that of gold. And we can see going further forward, this becomes slightly less achievable and realistically obtainable. If we go to 2060, suddenly Bitcoin is becoming the biggest asset on earth and is eating up every single dollar of value, every single asset's worth. Now, of course, being Bitcoin maxis, optimistic on the future of Bitcoin, we can all see this as a genuine possibility, but is it a realistic probability? Especially going forward to when the Bitcoin block reward is practically zero, we see Bitcoin worth quintillions of dollars. Now, of course, this is in today's money as well. Once we actually take into account the debasement and decrease in purchasing power of fiat currencies, these are going to astronomically increase as well. So again, I'm not saying that this is all unrealistic or something that we should be immediately concerned about, but it is something that we need to acknowledge going forward. However, what we can see is this doesn't seem to be disincentivizing miners too much. We can see the Bitcoin hash rate continuing to practically make new all-time highs every few weeks. If we just zoom in here, this has been on a very steady and constant uptrend, even as the Bitcoin price action recently was in a little bit of a downtrend and retracement. Even throughout the Bitcoin bear cycle, we've seen the Bitcoin hash rate continue to increase. And especially if we look at something like the Bitcoin hash ribbons indicator, what we can see, again, just zooming in, this is taking a 30 and 60 day moving average of the Bitcoin hash rate. We can see that the 30 day is actually storming way above the 60 day moving average, if I just zoom way in here. So this indicates that not only are we continuing to make new all-time highs, but we are accelerating to the upside. There is more and more mining activity, more and more computational power coming in to compete for the Bitcoin block rewards. But what we can see is along with this competition, it has never actually been less profitable to be mining Bitcoin. Now, of course, as mining equipment improves, their efficiency, potentially electricity becomes cheap with the renewable energy. This is going to slightly warp the statistics somewhat. But we can see looking at the Bitcoin hash price here, which is the USD or BTC expected profit for one terahash of power, we can see this has been on a very steady downtrend. And right now, the hash price for BTC would be about 0.5 BTC. Per one terahash of power per day. If we just compare that to a few years ago, this was multiple Bitcoin. If we go back to pretty much the start of 2022, this was over 5 Bitcoin, so a 10x decrease in just a few years. Now, the creator of the hash ribbons metric, who is Charles Edwards or Caprioli, actually has a really interesting metric that we're going to look at here, which is the production cost of Bitcoin. So this actually looks at the underlying production cost, the cost to mine a Bitcoin and the margins that they have. Because a lot of people, when you bring this up, say, yeah, of course, but electricity is going to get cheaper, mining equipment is going to get more efficient. But what we can see is if I just draw on the chart here, is the actual margins per cycle are diminishing rather rapidly. So if we look back to 2017, we can see that the margins for BTC profitability for miners was well over 500 towards 600%. In 2021 into 2022, well, just before that, this was somewhere around 200%. Yet the highest value we've seen this cycle after the most recent halving event is only around 40%, which again gives us some indication that maybe even though there are more and more miners coming into the network, that the actual margins for profitability are becoming smaller and smaller, especially alongside more and more people actually coming in to mine Bitcoin. The competitiveness is increasing exponentially, all while the incentives in terms of Bitcoin miner revenue and fees is diminishing rapidly, and the miner revenue in block reward looking like over the next decade or two, as I said, this isn't a problem for the immediate term, is becoming slightly concerning. But as we said, this is probably a fairly natural progression. As Bitcoin was much smaller, just a small speculative asset, people were probably pretty willing to do transactions in Bitcoin. We only have to look to about 15 years ago when someone paid 10,000 Bitcoin for just two pizzas. Whereas now people understand the opportunity cost of selling your Bitcoin now. People are looking to potentially hold on to their Bitcoin indefinitely. And now with the arrival of institutions, there's many Bitcoin being bought up that may never see the open market again. And Bitcoin's narrative has shifted from an electronic peer-to-peer currency into this international reserve asset. So it is a really interesting topic of discussion and something that we definitely need to acknowledge going forward, that Bitcoin does have this potential concern of how miners are actually going to be incentivized, how they are going to be rewarded for securing the Bitcoin network throughout the next 10, 20, 50, 100 years. Also, please don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications to ensure you're receiving all of our content as soon as it's released. And let me know in the comments below, do you think that this is a genuine concern for Bitcoin? Or do you think that by the time this actually becomes a problem in 5, 10, 15, 20 years, we'll have more incentives to actually reward miners and those securing the Bitcoin network? Maybe layer two solutions like the Lightning Network provide further incentives for people to secure Bitcoin and support transactions. But if you'd like to check out all the resources we discussed today, please visit bitcoinmagazinepro.com, where we have, well, not everything we discussed today, but most of the charts we discussed today, as well as many more that are all available. So just to summarize, what we're currently seeing on the Bitcoin blockchain is that blocks are pretty much empty, with fewer and fewer transactions happening on-chain, which is leading to miner revenue in fees plummeting to the lowest BTC-denominated levels we've seen in over 13 years. And what we can say is that this trend is likely to continue. As Bitcoin grows, there's likely to be less holders willing to part ways with their Bitcoin. No one's wanting to spend an asset or sell an asset that they think is going to go 5, 10x in the next few years. And really, no one wants to be that Bitcoin pizza guy who paid 10,000 Bitcoin just for two pizzas worth over $1 billion today. And again, this is a natural progression of Bitcoin, especially as it grows in terms of its market cap. As Bitcoin becomes a multi-trillion dollar asset, it's much easier to do international settlement of multi-billions of dollars and name another asset where you can do so for just a few cents. However, in spite of all of this, I don't think this is a genuine concern right now, even though I am seeing more and more people discussing this on social media platforms. However, it is something we need to acknowledge that is going to be a genuine discussion and talking point and potential concern for miner incentives in the next few years. If you like this video, then please visit bitcoinmagazinepro.com, where our analytics help you to cut through the noise to make informed data-driven decisions about Bitcoin. With over 150 live charts, personalized indicator alerts, in-depth crypto entry reports like the one you're seeing above here, which is actually a talking point we discussed a few weeks ago for site subscribers, discussing what happens when the Bitcoin block reward runs out, discussing a lot of the talking points we covered today, but as well as that, many other really interesting concepts and talking points discussing the topic. And as well as that, you get API access and a whole of a lot more, all for a fraction of the standard industry price. And as I said before, let me know what your thoughts are on this potential growing concern for Bitcoin and the incentive for miners. Do you think that this is something that we need to really consider and start planning towards the future for? Or do you think that this is something that we can just come to that problem when the time arises? As I said, let me know in the comments below and on social media. I look forward to reading and replying to them. Thank you all very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.